I have some poems for you. Now, some people would say that these poems, they are about love, and I say no. I say these poems, they are about life. All right. Your love is like the pouring rain. It makes me wet. Your love is like the lamppost is shining in the night. It the moths die when they fly towards the flame. Your love is like a picture frame. It has a photo of me and my prom date from high school. Your love, it is like the toilet water. My cat drinks it in between uses. Your love is like a car. It transports me from here to there. Your love, your love is like a flower. It is like a flower. And it is vibrant for 5 days, especially if you put bleach in the water. Your love, it is like a, clean underwear. It smells so good on my face. thank you. There is some applause here. Yes. Right. I am here every night except Thursday and Friday. Tip your waitress and buy a drink.
And today we have a rare opportunity to observe a unique breed of female, the woman who lives alone. We know that 44% of the US population is single, and we know that single motherhood is on the rise. But the specimen we're observing today is neither male nor is she a mother. She is young for this living situation, and you are directly outside of her window. Now, we won't know until she opens the curtain and we can see her living situation, exactly why she has chosen this life of solitude. But there are only two possibilities for this situation. She is either the owner of multiple felines, or she's a peasant. Let's find out, please.
She's approaching. Now she's entered the apartment. Will she open the blinds? Oh, excellent. Now let's see what she does. Notice that she has started to shed her outer layers. We can see that she is actually warm and violent because of this. Females tend to have lighter coats than males, so we may see her remove more layers than a male would before she gets down to her base coat. Look at that. How interesting. Here.
I do. What a beauty.
This behavior here is a territory claiming behavior. Some assume that all females are tidy, but here is evidence to the contrary. The fact that she has let her content spread all about is a strong statement. This is her space, and she is not going anywhere. Oh, fascinating. As you can see, we do not have cameras looking at her computer screen, so we can only speculate what she might be looking at on her computer. My first guess would be pornography. This female is not demonstrating the non-verbal behavior traditionally associated with human contact. The other option is most likely cat videos. Females of this variety are known for their fascination with cats. Even if this specimen is a feminist, it does not mean that she does not derive pleasure and relaxation from watching cat videos. How interesting. She has fallen asleep outside of the bedroom or sleeping area. Now, if you listen carefully, you can hear the noise she makes while sleeping. This is most likely intended to ward off predators while she is defenseless. You can see that she has also left the light on. Females are known for being jealous and skittish in dark spaces, so this choice makes absolute sense.
Just look at her sleeping. Oh, look at that. Oh, no. I'll not wake up. Damn.
What is interesting is we can see that this type of woman has an erratic sleeping pattern. Now, traditional women may need 6 to 8 hours of unbroken sleep, but this specimen is breaking that pattern.
Where'd you go, sweetheart? All right, come back now. Come on.
What a fascinating evening! The female has in fact changed clothing, closed the curtains, and turned out the light. There is no telling what she will do next. But you can be certain that we will stay right here outside her window and observe. Just for our viewers out there. Thank you for joining me, Robert Chase, in this rare glimpse into the female world.
loves me. He loves me. He loves me not. He loves me. He loves me not. Oh. He loves me. I love him. I love him. I love him not. I love him. I love him not. I love him. I love him not. I love him. I love him not, and I love him. I love him. I love him not. I love him. I love him not. I love him. I love him not. I love him. And I love him not. I love him. Love him not. I love him. Love him not. Love him. I love him not. I 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 love him. Not love. Not love. Not love. Not, yes, no, 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 yes, love. Not love, not no, yes, no, yes, love, not love, yes, no, I love him, I don't love, I don't love him. He loves me. I don't love him. Thank you.
I have for you tonight, Thea. Another poem. There once was a woman named Robin. She spent her every night sobbing. Her neighbors, all they heard. So they bought Robin a bird. Sings the one in the cage. Is no problem. I have a better one. You'll like this one. All right. There once was a man named Freck, whose lover, she told him, he stank. So Frank, he took a bath, lest his odor by half. And then his lover left him anyway, because apparently what she really liked was the love pheromones that were coming out of the body odor. You know, sometimes body odor is just the scent of love.
Robert Chase, and we have been watching this apartment diligently through the night, and there have been no more signs of movement from inside. The sun is coming up, so now is the time that we should start to see the female emerge. Unless, of course, the female has died through the night. When this happens to solo dwellers, especially young females, it can go unnoticed by the community for days. Even longer if the female owns cats, for they are known to consume the body, preventing the smell from alerting neighbors. But let's not assume the worst just yet. Let's keep an eye out for signs of life.
Water in here, vodka, whatever you would like to call it. She's coming back. She's not coming back.
She's coming back.
She's not coming back. But she's coming back. Call him again. You look like you need this. It's for you.